YCN segment is brought to you by Bubba's Bar and Grill on Lake Sunapee in Newberry Harbor.
Hi, I'm Elizabeth D'Orazio coming to you from Family Hotspot Beech Hill Farm right in Hockington, New Hampshire. And if you've driven by it recently, you've seen something new. You've seen this fabulous solar array behind me, and you probably asked, how did it get there and who built that? Well, we're here with the genius behind that, Rick MacMillan. He's the owner of Applied Solar Technologies. He's going to tell us what sets this system apart. Thank you for joining us.
You're welcome. I'm glad to be here.
So this system is kind of unlike some other ones. Tell us what makes it different.
Well, given the area that we're in here, this area is heavily covered with a lot of people, and it's trying to maintain a farm atmosphere here as well. Because in reality, it is a farm. The ice cream barn is wonderful, but in reality, it has to be a farm. So I spent a lot of time with the owners going back and forth over what it is they were looking for to do with the outside space and designed the system fully around that. The barns themselves are unique. They're vented at the top. So on this system, unlike most, you see just a flat layout of panels on the roof. This one is designed so the last two rows tip up a little more, which A, enhances snow release in the winter, and B, aesthetically is much more pleasing to the eye. Then also the ground array originally typically is about 7 feet off the ground on this system. We moved that up to over 10 feet so they could fit hay wagons and equipment under it, thereby not losing any space.
And I think that's something we commonly see as, you know, solar arrays. They're either on people's houses or in their backyards, and they kind of take up the entire space. When you drive up here, you almost don't recognize this because it's hidden.
Right. So they want people to know they have solar, because solar-powered ice cream is kind of a cool thing, and we're pretty excited about that. But yes, the space had to be usable. A lot of ground mount systems take up a given amount of ground space. They did not want to lose land to pasture land. They wanted to be able to run the farm as a farm and not really notice that the solar was here from their standpoint.
And this doesn't sacrifice how much power they're actually getting out of it. This is a massive system, people. And I mean, really, are they even using electricity at this point?
This will zero their electricity, although in the summertime, you typically produce twice as much power as you do in the winter. However, it works really well for Beech Hill Farm because they have walk-in freezers, all the freezers for the ice cream, and a lot of use in the summer. And their use actually tapers off a little bit in the winter. So it works very well with the sun, which, if you think about it, that's what farming is. Farming's more of a summertime activity than a January activity.
And solar really has become very popular in recent years, but I think what sets you apart in projects like this is the fact that you tailor it not only to the geography and the people's use of the property, but realistic expectations as to how much power is going to come out of here.
Exactly. It's a month-by-month analysis showing, you know, when we're feeding a little extra into the grid and when we're buying some back for the grid. And I try to parallel that as much as possible. We've done a really good job here. The ground mount also, another advantage of this system that we added when we were trying to determine which ground mount system to use, is these system panels on the ground mount are adjustable. They're manually adjustable. It's a little crank like a Velux window type thing. So they can be tilted up to 65 degrees in the winter, primarily because the sun is that low.
Changing, yeah.
And a lot of people in the solar that are buying solar don't really pay much attention to that, but I lived off grid for 10 years and I learned the value of the winter sun. So by adjusting those panels as little as four times a year, they'll pick up probably 15 to 20% more power output than they would just on a fixed ground ray.
Sounds like we've got you as the expert. So if you're thinking of going solar, whether you have a farm or a residential or a business opportunity, make sure you contact Rick from Applied Solar Technologies. From start to finish, they help coordinate everything from the permitting even to the electrical. They're going to take care of all of your solar needs.